Hi.
Finally,
I'm so
finally.
sorry. But we are depending on technology, yeah? I mean, now technology is taking us for granted.
I know, and usually I am the one who always has bad Wi-Fi and bad network because
Not me.
my house is like a Vipassana house where the network is so low that you never even get calls through. So
Oh
I'm
my
glad it's
God.
happening to somebody else
I
right now.
swear. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. I think the last time we met was during the promotions of Mirzapur in Delhi, right?
Yes.
It's
And
been, I
what a
think, 2 years.
show it was. And you have a second season coming up.
Yes, we do. And I think back then, I'm not sure if we met when it had just released or it was just releasing. I
It
think it
was
was on the
just
cusp.
releasing. Yeah.
Yeah, it was on the cusp of releasing. So, as you know, it was a boom for all of us once that happened.
You did a movie called House Arrest. Now,
Yes.
literally, from real to real, the transition has happened.
It's bizarre. And in fact, I just realized that it's been a year to that. Exactly last year, this time, I was shooting for House Arrest in Delhi with Ali. And the entire film was shot for in one house over a period of 1 month. And I was in both of us were in the same costume the whole time. And while we were shooting it, we kept thinking that कैसे होता अगर actually घर से निकल नहीं पाते एंड हियर वी आर.
You should have wished for something else or thought of something
Hey,
else.
one sec. None of us wished for any of it
Not
at
this.
all.
None of us wished for this.
None of us ever. But
Yeah.
it's interesting because even during the promotions of House Arrest, a lot of the interviews we would ask this question that for how long do you think you could be at home,
Yeah.
and at that point I felt like, I love being at home, so I have no qualms about it. But just given the circumstances we are in today, it's very different. It's just the fact that that it's unsafe to be out changes the ball game, altogether.
Very
So
true.
yeah.
So, how is self-isolation and social distancing treating you?
Well, the past 3 months I have been constantly shooting and I haven't been in Bombay. So this time period was actually meant as a break for me anyway, like just 1 week actually. But little did I know that the 1 week would extend for that long, of course. And I think for the first week it was just sort of it didn't really feel anything because I was like, I have to be at home. There are things to be done. I have to get some rest. I'm with family, so it's all fine. But I think it's slowly set in that this could be the new normal for a while now. And, it's really not about us anymore. It's not about what we feel or what, how we are coping because we're so privileged to be where we are right now,
True.
safely at home with our families, and we can practice social distancing. Whereas when we're watching what's happening today with people unable to reach their homes,
That's very tragic.
it's heartbreaking. It's
Yes.
heartbreaking. So I think there's just a sense of gratitude, and the least we can do is just be responsible and value what we have, abhi to,
Which is true. And also this moment, social distancing, we are all by ourselves. I think it's
Yeah.
giving everybody time to self-reflect. And there is this unity
Absolutely.
amongst everyone.
Absolutely. And I hope that's what's happening because I think social media, as you know, is so quick to put pressure on everything. Chalo chalo ghar pe hain, kya karoge abhi? Like just this pressure of productivity all the time. But I
Yeah.
feel it's so important to take your time to understand yourself in this situation also. And of course, there are so many things we usually don't have time for that we're able to do now. But even besides that, you don't have to come out of this quarantine with a book ready, Like everybody can just relax. They can just chill
Which
out.
is true. It's
Yeah.
true. And
Yeah.
if people are sitting and hoarding stuff, thinking it's like doomsday and they won't get food, that's very sad.
I know. I guess we just have to try and do our best to spread awareness through the process, and it's totally okay to be positive and not to really feel guilty about even that, because I think it happens to me sometimes, if you're posting something, you feel like there are people out there who are stranded and is it okay to share your comforts? But I feel like it's fine. You know, people need positivity also now. They need to feel that cheer on a day-to-day basis. So it's totally okay if people want to share if they're feeling happy and what they're doing through the day. That's also okay.
Which is true. And somebody's just asked a question saying, do you have pets and are you enjoying quarantine with them?
Yes, I do. In fact, my dog, he's outside somewhere, but I think every pet is the happiest now that their families are at home. So is my dog. His name is Jack. I adopted him 5 years ago. Oh. And he is the happiest that he's getting all our attention. And in fact, I had put up on Instagram a workout video recently that whenever I try to work out, he's around me all the time. So it's been nice. I think the biggest positive of this for me personally is that just being around family is rare. I mean, it's not that we're sitting together all the time and talking, but just to have them around, you know, because I have a lot of friends who are away from their family. So I feel quite grateful that I am in that comfort space. Aur khud khana banana nahi pad raha.
I know. A lot of people are grateful about that, which is true.
That's true.
And also, you know, social distancing, but we are actually now seeking human connection. And, you know, earlier we were like no screen time, not on the phone, but now thanks to this phone, you're all connected.
Now, yeah. Jack, come here. Jack, you want to say hi? Jack. That is my dog.
Hello, Jack.
Jack is showing his bum and he's left now. But you know, what you're saying is absolutely right, that we suddenly will value those hugs. We will value meeting people who we took for granted. You know, we'll just value the freedom because we didn't have to see those struggles, right? Ever. We didn't have to see any of that. So now it's a whole new different thing. Hi, baby. Say hi.
Hi, baby.
So also, I'd really like this opportunity to, you know, tell everybody watching that pets do not spread coronavirus. There are so many stories of people abandoning their animals. It's ridiculous.
It's tragic. And it's really tragic. It's really very upsetting. So also somebody's written, Guttu Bhaiya aur Sweetie, ab kya karenge Mirzapur 2 mein question aaya.
मैं सिर्फ इतना कहना चाहूंगी सबको कि मुझे जब से मिर्जापुर रिलीज हुआ है यही एक सवाल हर दिन मतलब 50,000 बार पूछा जाता है. पर अगर आपने पहला सीजन देखा है स्टार्ट टू फिनिश तो आपको पता होना चाहिए सीजन टू उनको पूछो जो सीजन टू में होंगे. मतलब आपको पता है मेरा कैसा अंत हुआ है सीजन तो मुझे क्यों पूछ रहे हैं लोग. No, I'm saying, और अगर आपको गुड्डू स्वीटी को किसी और अवतार में देखना हो तो हाउस अरेस्ट देख लीजिए नेटफ्लिक्स पे. इट्स क्वाइट एप्ट राइट नाउ.
अभी कोई हाउस अरेस्ट नहीं देखेगा. एक पीपल आर वॉचिंग कॉन्टेजियस एंड हाउस अरेस्ट तो भैया.
But House Arrest is it's a light film and it's voluntary house arrest. So Contagion, I think, is a wrong film to watch right now. It's freaked people out completely. Yeah. So we don't need more panic attacks and more WhatsApp gyan anymore.
Which is true. And now you're Haathi Mere Saathi with Rana Daggubati. You're making your debut, Tamil and Telugu debut.
Yes. And what was exciting was that it's a trilingual. So we shot each scene in Hindi, Tamil and Telugu. And the film was up for release on 2nd April, but of course everything is pushed now. So I don't know when the film will be out yet. And the story of the film also is so relevant because it talks about Bandev, played by Rana, his character who lives in a forest and he really fights for the land that belongs to the elephants and wants to stop illegal encroachment. And it's his fight, and it's such a beautiful film for everybody to watch. It has nothing to do with the Purana Haathi Mere Saathi. But I'm saying the subject is about coexistence. It is about humans not being entitled. I think as human beings we've only lived our life with a certain level of entitlement and feeling that we have the right to things, which we don't, you know. So please do watch the film when it comes out. It's made with a very, very good heart. So
awesome. And you know, you're talking about animals. Have you seen the skies are blue? The birds are chirping. I've heard about dolphins, you know, coming to closer to the shore.
And I saw some videos of even deers in Noida, Delhi, mein kahin ghoom rahe hain.
There was a picture. There was the turtles. Scott turtles were out.
You know, that it's almost like animals have found this freedom and they don't have fear and they're actually coming out and owning their space.
Which is true.
Yeah,
it's like dogs are sitting outside the strays and I like, you know, have the humans been taken away by the Nagar Nigam, literally.
Yeah, absolutely. But it's quite nice. And it's so funny because everybody keeps talking about like how, you know, the birds are chirping. I'm like, the birds always chirped. We just didn't have time to listen to it, you know. And now we're just over observant.
Now somebody is asking, when are you doing a Marathi film next?
As soon as I get a script that I really like. A lot of people think I'm not doing Marathi films at all, but that's not true. As you know, I love working in different languages. For me, the script is important. You know, it could be in any language. My first film was a Marathi film. My second film was a French film. I'm doing Tamil, Telugu now. So for me, I've always wanted to work in different industries and in different languages. That really excites me. So जेव्हा चांगली स्क्रिप्ट मला मिळेल तेव्हा मी काम करीन.
अरे क्वाइट अ लिंग्विस्ट यू आर यार.
नो, आई एम नो लिंग्विस्ट. आई थिंक इट्स व्हेरी एक्साइटिंग टू वर्क विद डिफरेंट पीपल विद डिफरेंट एस्थेटिक्स एंड यू नो डिफरेंट फिल्म इंडस्ट्रीज. देयर इज सो मच लवली वर्क हैपनिंग एवरीवेयर.
आई नो यू ऑल सेट टू डू एन एक्शन फिल्म आल्सो एंड वी सी यू डूइंग एक्शन पैकिंग इन पंचेस.
यस, इट्स नॉट अ फिल्म, इट्स अ सीरीज.
Okay.
Saqib Saleem is in it. I believe you guys did a chat yesterday.
Yesterday, and we spoke only cricket.
Yeah, of course. Because even the director of Crackdown, that's the series I'm doing, Apoorva Lakhia is directing it. He also is a big cricket fan, and Saqib, of course, did 83. So I've always wanted to do action, to be honest. And this series is, I mean, it's going to see me play two very distinct characters. One like badass with like short hair, a different look altogether. And the other one I can't tell you about as yet. I don't want to reveal anything. But yeah, I'm excited for it. Some interesting stuff coming up this year. I don't know if this year hoga ki next year hoga. But
I know. Your schedules have all gone haywire. I've never seen the film industry ever stop. Come what may.
Yeah.
But a virtual lockdown.
No, and also because there are so many people on a set.
Yeah.
There is just no way to contain that situation then. So, and I think right now, more than anything else, priority is health and let everything settle down a little bit because we are here to stay and all the stuff that we've, as actors, as artists all around the world, everything that they've done across generations, people are now sitting at home and consuming. And that makes me realize that I feel so happy to be part of this industry because in times like this, you're able to provide entertainment in some way.
And talking about entertainment, what are you watching? What's on your watch list?
Every day there's something different. I actually do a combination of series and films. So I'm currently just finished watching two seasons of Killing Eve. Have you heard of the show?
Yes, of course. I've seen the first season. I couldn't stomach it, so I left it.
You couldn't stomach the...
No, I couldn't. There's too much of killing. I love romance.
Fair enough. So I've been catching a lot of animation films on Netflix. Studio Ghibli films, Japanese films. And there's an amazing film called I Lost My Body, which is on Netflix, which I really like. So I've been... So I've been watching different kinds of things every day. Sorry?
We saw you work out. What's your routine like? Like, you have 24 hours just like in front of you.
Every day is different. It's not like I have a timetable chalked out where I do, you know, XYZ in certain amount of time. But I think the only thing I've told myself is I have to be consistent with exercising because that takes away lethargy and there's a sense of doing something, you know, pushing yourself a little bit. So personally, I feel like that really keeps me, it energizes me instead of making me feel lazy. So every day I'll do, I have a skipping rope. So, you know, even if it's skipping and doing home Pilates or sometimes just watching videos and doing that. My trainer, Swapnil Kokam, he has, you know, sent me videos of like guiding me about how I can do it. So I think because of the internet today, at least you can sort of, you have all these things available to you. And I realized I have a superpower of taking endless naps.
Because you've been deprived because of your shoot schedules.
No, no, that's fine. But I didn't know I was capable of just napping so much.
I guess
I've discovered this. I'm amazed. My mother's amazed that I'm doing that so much.
And talking about your parents, people are asking, what are Sachin Kaka and Supriya Kaki doing?
This Kaka Kaki kab se ho gaye?
Teen-char logon ne likha hai.
I think there's a feeling of love and of course affinity that they have.
True.
They're also ghar pe, I think, wahi, everyone is just doing their own thing. We try and have at least one meal together, either lunch or dinner, because sabki timings kabhi kabhi alag hote hain. So, meri mummy ki hamesha complaint hoti hai ki hum dining table pe ek saath baith ke nahi khate. Usually, it, because of our schedules, sab, you know, it's different. But because of this, at least one meal we have at home. Throughout the day, I'm just getting yelled at for not cleaning properly because ghar pe safai karni hoti hai. So, there's lots of things to do actually. Something or the other is always happening and it's just nice to be around them. I'm always forcing them to like play board games and do this and do that.
I can imagine. Somebody has asked which Hogwarts house do you belong to?
I don't want to assume what house I would be. I'd need to wear a hat and see. But I think, see, the Gryffindor are all very, like, goody-goody, right? But I feel the Slytherins have a lot of magic in them. There's a lot of, like, mystery to the Slytherins. So maybe, I don't know, maybe I would belong to the Slytherins.
Your fans are really clued in with what you like and what you're interested in.
Oh, really? What are they saying?
No, they've been asking about the house. They're concerned about Mirzapur. Then they ask me, aap Prabhas ke saath picture kab karoge? Ek ye sawal bhi aaya hai.
Prabhas, jab hi ek film milegi, tab kar lungi. Abhi to nahi mili hai.
I mean,
abhi to pata nahi kab hoga. But I would actually like to tell viewers that a lot of people don't know, but I did a British series last year called Beecham House.
Oh, yes, directed, during the shutdowns, right?
Yeah, so that is on Netflix. So for those who want to watch like a period drama, it's a nice, fun show to watch. And it's beautifully shot because it's set in 1795.
Wow.
So that's also on Netflix if you guys want to catch it.
Thank you so much. Lovely talking to you. Keep safe.
Likewise, and, yes.
And hope we connect soon in person.
Absolutely. Next time I come to Delhi, I'll call you and hopefully we can go out and eat some good food and chat.
Exactly. And by the way, your DIY trip tip on volume, you know, after the gym.
You remember?
It actually works. So do you have any other one? I saw you with red lipstick sitting at home, all dressed and nowhere to go.
Well, you should tell people what you're talking about. They might not have a context to it.
I know. She has a DIY tip. In case you want volume in your hair, after the gym, just sit in an auto. It will give your hair a bounce. And it works.
That's true. See, it's natural sweat. Right now, my hair is sweaty and it's bouncy, right? Look, because it has sweat in it. I'm telling you, to speak to you today, I wore some lipstick and I wore like an accessory because I felt like I should just do make some effort because I've been in my pajamas all day.
Business pajamas. We are all in our business pajamas.
But it's fine, you know, whatever makes you happy and whatever, you know, just sort of gets you mentally stimulated, just do that. Don't worry about what people have to say.
Very true. Thank you so much. Keep safe.
Thank you.
And hope
yes,
to see you,
you
soon.
Too.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Take care. Bye-bye.
Bye.